Now, he has asked a question, maybe I think we haven't even gone to that level, haven't even discussed the closed loop control of a DC to DC converter. Now, battery charging. So that is a conventional battery charging, constant current, constant voltage, trickle charging. This, yeah. These are, to be very honest with you, I don't think the techniques which you are asking, those are generally used in switch mode power conversion. I don't think they are relevant in solar power conversion. How to improve the response time? Now, see my please don't get perturbed. We talk about MPPT. My response time I have improved. Okay, I am asking a question. Fine, I have not improved my response time. My bit sluggish. What am I losing? Not. Be very honest. Let us be very critical. What am I losing? If my response time is lower by say 10 milliseconds, what am I losing? Kitna apati, kya apati aayegi, kya kuch, humko pata nahi hai. In the sense, is it something fuel is burning there in a sense I have to recover? And response time. And another thing is the sun insulation changes so instantaneously? Now, please don't get perturbed. My due respect to people whoever is working in MPPT. But for me, according to me, they are splitting your hair. There are other issues to worry about. Now, don't get how to improve the response time. These are all very important issues, maybe in the drives and where 20 milliseconds is a lot of time. Are you with me? Say, for example, 20 milliseconds. See, when the locomotive is going in this one, pantograph jumps, right? 20 milliseconds. Suppose if there are disconnected, your pantograph get disconnected by 20 milliseconds. Entire 1 MVA power per megawatt of power, that capacitor has to supply. Are you with me? If the capacitor voltage falls by 70%, your control circuit trips saying that is under voltage. These are very important issues there. I don't think this so-called improving response time and those things are issues in solar. If those issues have to be addressed, maybe give me a slot, I will come and talk to you. Otherwise, you come, maybe sometime later we will discuss. Are you with me? Now, please don't get perturbed. Let us concentrate on the issue which is going to make a small impact rather than. Now, please don't. This is not the answer to your question. Trying to respond, improving my response time by using a MPPT this one time. For me, according to me, these are non-issues. Fine, you can improve the control algorithm response time. It's all okay, fine, work. If you get the publication out of you and if you are happy, go ahead. Yeah, yesterday I asked you, what are the questions that I've asked? I forgot about the question, give us the answer. What are the questions that I had asked? The question that I had asked was, the so-called MPPT gets extract the maximum power or whatever the power that is available from the solar cell, it dumps in the capacitor. Okay. Okay. Now that power has to be fed to the grid. How do I determine how much power to feed? Which control loop? Where is the control loop which will tell you this amount of power has to be? It has to be online. Are you with me? It has to be online, like an MPPT, that operating point goes on changing. The so-called, if I use a hill climbing method, every sample, it calculates the power, compares with the previous. If it is less, it changes operating point. Are you with me? It may be it's maybe sampling time could be as small as 1 millisecond or so. Now, similarly, here, I have to feed the power to the grid. How much of power to feed? How do I determine? Who will tell you? Who will tell you? That one question we need to answer. Okay. Another thing is, as we have discussed, a two-level inverter, a conventional voltage source inverter, voltage output voltage varies from plus VDC to minus VDC, plus VDC to minus VDC. So we found that the dV/dt is very high. Okay. So there is a lot of stress on the device, leave alone to your load. Okay. How do we address? As the power level increases, See, as the power level increases, my DC link voltage may have to be, may have to increase the DC link voltage. Okay. So under that condition, is this two level inverter, the conventional voltage source inverter, is it suitable, or can we modify the structure? Can we modify the structure? See, I am telling you, I will just ask a question. What the PWM inverter does? There are large number of pulses, right? Large number of pulses, and we told that initial, if I apply these pulses to an RL circuit, initial portion is linear. Okay. So somehow I get a sinusoidal current. Now assume, instead of having this sort of a waveform, if I have I've just drawn the half a cycle. Somewhat symmetrical. Okay. Do I need to have, is there a need for a large number of pulses? Come on, if I have a waveform something like this, which is better? First one is better or the second one is better? Second, it looks, if there are more number of terms, it looks approximately a, it's approximately a sine wave, approximately a sine. There are more than two levels, hence the name multilevel, So you may have to change the power circuit configuration itself. I'm telling you, I told you that in a DC to DC converter, there is a DC to AC inversion, and again we are converting it. Okay. For in order to reduce the filter size requirement, this is one solution. Use multilevel. I told you that half wave converter, full wave converter, three phase converter, capacitor requirement or filter requirement is minimum in three phase. So similarly, if I have to reduce the, this is the solution, stress on the device, if I have to reduce, multilevel is a solution. Multilevel is a solution in a grid connected inverter as well, to feed the power to the grid for high power. Your multilevel inverter VA0 is either plus or minus VDC by 2, or VAX is VDC or 0, VAX. Okay, as the power level increases, VDC has to increase. See, another thing, as the power level increases, VDC has to increase and switching frequency has to come down. I told you 250 watt switching frequency is of the order of, this gentleman said around 250 to 400 kilohertz. For 1 MVA inverter, switching frequency reduces to, so around 550 to 600 hertz. So, see, so the moment the switching frequency, the frequency of the predominant harmonic in a two level inverter, frequency of the predominant harmonic is approximately equal to switching frequency. Come on, in a sinusoidal PWM technique, sine wave is compared with triangular wave, okay. If the triangular wave frequency, the frequency of the triangular wave will determine switching frequency. Are you with me? If the frequency of the triangular wave is 550 hertz, what is the harmonic spectrum? It has a fundamental component whose frequency is same as the modulating wave. Come on. No. This I did not cover thinking. What is the sinusoid? These are sine versus triangle. Okay. Fundamental frequency is equal to frequency of the modulating wave. Okay. Are you with me? If that is 50, this is also 50. Okay. If this is FS, switching frequency, okay, the harmonic spectrum, what is the frequency of the predominant harmonic for a sinusoidal asynchronous PWM? Approximately, FS plus or minus 1. here. See, there are two side bands somewhere here. Somewhere, what is the frequency? If I call this as F triangle, this is, and this is F sine, this is approximately F triangle minus Fs, and this is F triangle plus Fs. Okay? So switching frequency of the triangular wave is 550 hertz. So frequency of the predominant harmonic is around hertz. That is relatively low. It is less than 11. Are you with me? Less than 11th harmonic. So we have a problem in a two level. As the frequency, as the power level increases, as the power level increases, DC link voltage increases and switching frequency comes down. If the switching frequency comes down, frequency of predominant harmonic also comes down. That will affect your THD. So you may have to design a separate L and C output filter to handle this. Okay. So is there a solution? Solution, instead of having two levels in a VA0, increase the number of levels. As the number of level increases, Vn becomes approximately a step sine wave. It looks approximately a sine wave now. Are you with me? After all, sine is what? There are large number, infinite number of steps. Only then I can get a smooth sine wave. Ayana. So fire a conventional theory, yeah, predominant harmonic is low. So here, I'll just show you. Instead, modify the inverter structure, more than two multi-level inverter, three-level inverter. There are various types of multi-level inverters: diode clamp, flying capacitor, okay, type, or cascaded. I will discuss diode clamp, and the cascaded. Cascaded is a bit attractive for solar. I'll tell you. Okay, this also got it. It's a three-level inverter. Just see the structure. Okay, this is one leg of the inverter. This is one leg. This is one leg. One leg of an inverter. Conventional VSI, one leg of inverter. There are only two devices. See here now, this is one device. Voltage source inverter always requires a switch in parallel with the diode. This is one device, S1, S2, S3, S4. Okay? Are you with me? We did use center point of the DC link as the reference point. Are you with me? I told you that is not important for three phase. Half bridge yet it is required. Here it is required. This is the center. You have to split the entire DC link into two. This is the center point. Are you with me? And see the connection. I have to use two additional diodes. For a three level. As the level changes, power circuit changes, I will tell you. It looks a bit scary, but then it isn't. Okay. At any given time, three level inverter. At any given time, n minus, this is a general rule, n minus 1 switches are on in each leg. Okay. At any given time, n minus 1 switches are on in each leg. In each leg, only one switch is on there, n minus 1. N is the number of levels. If n is equal to 3, 2 switches are on. That is S1, S2, either S1, S2 or S2, S3 or S3, S4. ठीक है? S1, S2 on. What is VAX? X is the middle point. S1, S2 on. Okay, tell me. S1, S2 on. What is VAX? VAX is the entire DC link voltage. S1, S2 on. These two are on. This point A is gets connected to plus VDC. So VAX is VDC. That, okay, see here. S1, S2 on. So So voltage source inverter current as current will be bidirectional, positive current as well as negative. If the current is positive, it will flow through S1, S2. Are you with me? If the current is negative, it will flow through D1, D2, and capacitor. Are you with me? The freewheeling diodes of S1, S2. So voltage is VAX is VDC. VDC. S3, S4 on. Sorry, S2, S3 on. S2, S3 on. What is VAX? S2, S3 on. Yeah, S2, S3 on. Just see this point, either it gets connected here or it gets connected here. Ayana, it is a short. Okay. So VAX is start from here, capacitor. Okay. Now current could be either positive or negative. It can flow in or flow out. The voltage source inverter. Or if it is flowing in, okay. Don't worry, here is the circuit. S1, S2 on. Positive direction of current. Positive direction of current. Negative direction of current. Negative direction of current. Okay? And last one is S3, S4 on. S3, S4 on. VAX is 0. VAX is 0. Positive direction of current is through D3, D4. Positive direction of current. Negative direction of current is through S3, S4, S3, S4. This is for 3 level. Number of capacitors required are N minus 1, N minus 1. Number of switches required are 2N minus 1. As the number of switches increase, looks as the number of levels increases, number of switches also will increase. Attending, okay. So 4 per phase, 2n minus 1. Okay. Number of diodes that are required, I don't want to give you right now, maybe sometime later I will tell you. Okay. From here it looks as if there are only 2. We will see whether it is 2 or something else, we will see. Any questions? Number of diodes, look, I put a question mark. Okay. The 4 level inverter, I will just show you. Then I will not discuss. So in detail, 3 level inverter, some issues, important issues I will discuss and I will go. 4 level inverter, 4 level, number of switch, at any given time N minus 1 switches are on. Now see the connections here, capacitor required are N minus 1, are you with me? N minus 1, so there are 3 capacitors, okay. And here number of devices are 2 N minus 1. 2n minus 1, n is 4, so n minus 1 is 3, 2 into 3 is 6, 6 devices, and each device has a freewheeling diode across it. I have not shown for other diode. Okay. See the connections, it bit tricky is not, what you have to do is, top one, this is the output point, this is the output point, top one and immediately after one device from the output point, take two diodes, connect back to back, sorry, connect in this fashion, and it goes to topmost capacitor. This is a rule to be followed as the number of level increases, same rule, one here, immediately one, diode connection, common point goes to capacitor, second, diode goes to the second capacitor. This is the rule to be followed as the level increases. 3 level it is obvious, 4 level it looks a bit tricky, as 5 level increases it looks really confusing, but then you follow this rule. 1 1 back, first capacitor, okay, second back to this point. Now we will see, I will just show you how it works. At any given time, 3 switches are on, S1, S2, S3. What is the output voltage? S1, S2, VIX is VDC. I must have given here, yeah. S1, S2, S3 on. Positive direction of current is through S1, S2, S3, and negative direction is D1, D2, D3. Okay? D1, D2, D3. Okay. S2, S3, S4 on. At any given time, 3 switches are on. You turn off one S1 and turn on S1 off, S4 close. Trace it, simple. Start from here. Positive direction of current. Okay. Negative direction of current, what is VIX? 2/3 VDC, 2/3 VDC. S3, S4, S5 on, what is the output voltage? So S1, S2 on, sorry, S1, S2 off, S3, S4 on, so voltage is positive direction of current, negative direction of current, negative direction of current, VDC by 3. Now I will open S3, close S6, close S6, 0, 0, positive direction as well as negative direction. Is that okay? Now, what are our observations? 4 level inverter. 4 level in the sense there are 4 levels. What are our observations? So the number of levels is a bit advanced, but let us see here. What are the issues? Huh? No, that is okay. More number, that is required. What are the, see, there are 6 devices, see here, for maximum voltage, no, maximum voltage S1, S2, S3 on, that is, if I, in an envelope, see here, assume that this is an envelope, maximum voltage that appears only for a short duration, ayana. So in this duration, maximum voltage, all the 3 upper switches are on, are you with me? In this, only 2 are on. Which are 2? Lower 2. No, voltage, average, see the duty cycle for the devices is not the same. Are you able to understand or no? Here all the upper switches, all 3 switches are on. What happens here? The topmost switch has gone off. But lower are continue to remain on. Here, the topmost 2 are gone on. Here, yeah. So if you see, in this entire zone, that this one, no, lower on, this one, for one third, the device, which device is continuously on? S3 is continuously on. In the second level, S2 is on and S1 is on for a very short duration, only in that peak. Yeah, so duty cycle is not the same. Duty cycle is not the same. Duty cycle is not the same. So maybe you may have to really worry about the heat duty cycle is not the same, conduction period and all those things may be different. Okay, is that okay? Voltage rating of each switch is the same. What about these diodes? Why did I put a question mark there? What is the voltage rating of DA? What voltage it has to block? DA has to block only 1/3 of VDC. See, when S1 is closed, listen to me, when S1 is closed, this point gets connected here, Ayana. Anode is here, cathode is here. So voltage rating of DA is 1/3. Okay. What is the voltage rating of DA dash? You close S5, S6. Sometime in during the time S5, S6 are closed. Ayana. Come on. Sometimes S5, S6 are closed. When S5, S6 are closed, what is the voltage? When S5, S6 are closed, this point gets connected to negative DC bus. This point gets connected to negative DC bus. Whereas cathode is connected here. What is the voltage rating? 2/3 VDC. 2/3 VDC. So voltage rating. So you have a choice. Now you need to make a choice. Use diodes of different voltage rating, or two diodes of same voltage rating. Same voltage, the losses and whatnot. See, inventory versus. The moment I use two diodes, what are the issues? See, if all the diodes are of same voltage rating, I have to buy only one type of diodes and stock them. Ayana, now I have different diodes rating. I need to have different stock. Inventory increases. Now to reduce that, you are using the diodes of same voltage. What price you are paying, sir? What price are you paying? No, forget that. I'm not talking about performance wise. No, series diode is saying some issues. Now, can I mount them on the same heat sink? Heat sink body, maybe anode, maybe the body. Ayana, you have to mount it on the heat sink. Okay, that may be either anode or a cathode. Potential of two anodes is not the same, so I don't think I can mount. Same heat sinks. You may have to separate them. Plus, overall losses, you have to find out high voltage diode versus two low voltage diodes. How the voltage rating is, how do you increase the voltage rating? We need not know much, but then how do you increase the voltage rating? It has to, doping level has to increase, the doping level has to come down. Doping level has to, they are lightly doped. Okay, the moment you lightly dope them, what happens to T off? Off time. Diode also has to turn off. No. It may be an uncontrolled device. It has to also turn off. Whether T off will increase or decrease? Increase or, okay, fine. So you have to pay a price for the conversion. And you have to decide what exactly to. So this is number of diodes is not here four. If you have four, of course, they are different current rating or voltage rating. Sorry, different voltage rating. If you want to use same diodes, the expression here is number of diodes is n minus 1 into n minus 2. Either you have to connect only one diode or of higher voltage rating or same diodes. Voltage rating is not the same.